Hi guys, welcome back to the session. Today we will create a project in Automation Anywhere to automate a task from this RPA Challenge website. So let's get started. So this is a RPA Challenge website where there are different tasks provided for automation. We are going to automate this task, that is input forms. Here there is an option to download the Excel sheet. So once you download the Excel, you will get a spreadsheet like this. So what we need to do in the task, for each of these rows from this spreadsheet, we need to provide the field values over here. Click on submit and do the same activity again for each of these rows in the spreadsheet. Now if you notice over here, the field where positions gets changed every time we click on the submit button. So we provide the field values over here, click on the submit. You see the field positions get changed. Why the field positions are getting changed? Because the HTML properties for all these fields are dynamic and changes for every round. Now this is the challenge for this RPA task. We need to provide the values from this spreadsheet into the correct fields over here. And we can do so by identifying the HTML properties for all these fields which are not changing for every iteration. So let's see how we can do that. I have already created one task in Automation Anywhere. We'll quickly run the task to see how this automation works, and later on we are going to create the task together. So I'm going to close this RPA challenge. I'm going to close this spreadsheet as well. Let's see how this task works. So click on run. And the URL is getting launched now. Now it is opening the spreadsheet. And now the loop command is running. And now it is providing the field values for all these fields for the first round. And the first round fields has been provided. Clicked on submit. Now the round 2 is in progress. The bot is providing the field values for the second round. And once it is done, the bot will click on the submit. So round 2 done successfully. Now it is in the round 3. And you can see the position of all these fields are getting changed. So we are in round 4 now, and you can see the positions has been changed again. And the bot is providing the values for the fields. Clicked on submit, and same for the 5th round. And now the 6th round is in progress. And all done for the 6th round. Now it will provide the values for round 7. And in all the iterations, you can notice the field positions are getting changed. Now goes the round 8. So 2 more to go. There were 10 rows in the spreadsheet. So now we are in round 9. And here comes the final round, that is the 10th one. And it is over. He's saying that your success rate is 100%, that is 70 out of 70 fields has been completed successfully. So now let's create this task together from scratch. So I will reset this one, and we got the fields again. Now the first and the foremost thing which we need to do here is to analyze the HTML properties for all these fields. So let's start with this company name. If you right click over here and click on inspect. So here the HTML properties for this company name field is highlighted. So if you right click over here and copy the element and let's put it over here. Let's paste it over here. Now if I click on submit and if I select the property again, right click over here and inspect. Now this is the property of the company name. So if I copy this one as well, copy element and if I paste it over here. So from here we need to identify the property of the company name which is not changing and which makes the company name field as unique. So this ID is set to be the tag, this ng reflect name, ID, name and class are set to be the attributes. Now here you see the value of ID is changing in both the iterations. The value of name is also changing in both the iterations. So we cannot consider this ID and name. Now if you look at this ng reflect name, this is not changing. So we can consider this ng reflect name. And also if you notice this class, this is also not changing, but we cannot consider this because it is not making the company name field as unique as other fields also has the same class name. So if you notice over here, if I take the properties of some other field, so if I take the property of this role in company, right click over here, click on inspect. So here you see the class is similar. If I copy this one from here, let's copy this one and let's paste it over here. Let's paste it over here. You see the class for role in company field and class for company name field are similar. So this class name cannot be considered to identify the element uniquely. So what we analyzed to identify the element uniquely in every iteration, we can consider this ng reflect name. Now to identify the element, we need to write an XPath. XPath is a syntax which is used to find a particular element on a web page. Now there are different ways to write a XPath. We can write absolute XPath, we can write relative XPath. So I'm going to go with the relative XPath because it is robust. So to write the XPath, what we need to do, we need to put double slash, then we need to write the tag name. So this is the tag name input I mentioned. This input is the tag name. Now instead of this tag name, you can put a star as well. Now I'm not going with the star. Let's put the tag name and we need to provide the brackets and under the bracket we need to put at the rate and with this at the rate we need to provide the attribute name. So let's copy this attribute name from here. Let's paste it over here. Equal to and then we need to write the attribute value. So let's copy this one here and under the quotes I'm going to write the value. So this is the XPath ready to identify the company name field. Now to test whether this XPath is working or not, what we can do, let's copy this from here and if I put a control F, so here we can search the XPath. So if I paste the XPath over here, you see this company name field gets highlighted. This yellow one is the property of the company name. So you see by this XPath, this is getting highlighted. So this XPath we need to use in our project. So if I show you what I did, so I use this capture option and you remember in the capture action we have the object properties. So here we need to provide the DOM XPath which we created just now. So we created the XPath for the company name. In a similar way we are going to create the XPath for other fields as well. So let's quickly create the XPaths. We have 7 fields over there. Let's remove this one and in a similar way let's provide the XPath of for other fields. So we are done with the company name. Let's put the XPath for role in company. Let's right click and inspect. So here you also see this ng reflect name is label role. So I'm going to take this label role from here and under the attribute ng reflect name I'm going to provide the value as label role. To check this one you can check, let's copy it one from here and let's paste it over here. You see this role in company got reflected. Now in a similar way I will do for the first name as well. So to inspect we can inspect from here as well. You can select this one arrow and if you inspect this one, so the property for this first name gets reflected. This is the ng reflect name value. Let's copy it from here and let's paste it over here. Let's look into the next one. Next one is email. So let's inspect this one as well. Same attribute I'm going to take for the email field as well. That is ng reflect name value. So let's copy this one from here. Let's paste it over here. And next with us is the address. So let's inspect this address as well. Take the label address from here. Let's paste it over here. Then I'm going to take the phone number. Let's take the label phone from here. Let's paste it over here. Also, the last item with us is the last name. So let's inspect this as well. This is the label last name. And let's paste it over here. So all done, we have identified all the XPaths for all of these 7 fields. We also need to identify the XPath for these 2 fields. Now once we start filling these values, we need to click on this start button. So let's inspect this as well. Right click over here, click on inspect. So this is the property of this start button. So I'm going to write the XPath for this as well. So here you see the tag name is button and I'm going to take the attribute as class. So let's copy the class value from here and I'm going to write the XPath as double slash. I'm going to provide the tag name as button and attribute I'm going to take as class and this is the value. Next we need to write the XPath for this submit button as well. So let's inspect this as well. So here also the tag name is input and I'm going to take the attribute as type, that is the value is submit. So let's copy this one and let's provide the value over here. Let's provide the tag name as input and let's provide the type equal to and the value is submit. So all done, all the XPaths has been identified. Let's quickly move back to Automation Anywhere and let's create a new project. So for that we'll move to bots and my bots. From my bots I'm going to create new bot. Let's give the name of the bot as RPA challenge and let's click on create and edit. So here we are in the edit task bot page. Let's quickly add actions to our project. So first action I'm going to use is to launch this website. So let's search for the launch action. So this is the launch website action. Let's drag and drop it over here. Let's move to list view and here we need to provide the URL. So let's take this URL from here. Let's paste it over here. And then we have the option to select the browser. Let's go with the browser as Chrome. Let's click on apply. Now the action has been added to launch the RPA challenge website. Then we need to open the spreadsheet as well. So I'm going to add the action open from Excel basic. Let's drag and drop it over here. And here we need to provide the spreadsheet path. So let's select this desktop file and let's click on browse. Let's take the challenge file from here. This is an XLSX file. Let's click on open and let's open that file manually as well. So this is the spreadsheet from where we need to provide the field values. So let's click on apply. And since we have added the open action, we need to add the close action as well at the end. So let's add the close action as well from the end. So let's drag and drop the close action over here. Now the website is launched, Excel is opened. Then we need to click on this start button. Now to do so, I'm going to add the capture action. So this is the capture action under the recorder package. Let's drag and drop it over here. And since this needs to be done only one time, we need to click on this start button only one time, so that need not to be inside the loop. So let's provide the details for this capture action. So first we need to provide the object details. So let's select the window. So from here we need to identify the window, which will be this RPA challenge URL. Now we might need to identify the elements from here. So I'm going to open this URL in another window. Let's open another window for that. And let's move back to Automation Anywhere. Let's refresh the windows. And from the drop down, let's select the window from here. So this is the RPA challenge window which we need to select. Let's select this one. And let's click on this capture object. So let's click on this capture object. And from here we want to capture this start button. So let's click on this start. And it is getting recorded. And the object has been captured. Now we'll have to focus on the object properties. So here we have different properties present. We are going to remove this DOM XPath and we are going to take the XPath which we have created. So this is the XPath which we have created for the start button. Let's copy it one from here and let's paste it over here. And we don't need to select all these properties, so we are going to uncheck these options. HTML type, let's keep this one. Let's keep the HTML type as submit. Let's remove this one. We don't need to take this path property. So what we did, we have selected the properties HTML type, we have selected the DOM XPath property and the HTML tag. Now if you click on this object properties, you see these all are the 5 mandatory properties which are required. Apart from that, other properties are not required. So we have not selected those one. And next we need to select the action. So let's select the action as click. We need to click on that one and let's click on apply. Now once we click on this start button, then we are going to start the loop to loop through each of these rows and provide the values over here. So let's add the loop action. So I'm going to add the loop action from here. Let's drag and drop it over here. And we need to select the iterator type. So from this drop down, let's select the iterator type as for each row in worksheet for this Excel basic. Since we have taken this Excel basic package, so let's select this one. And the session name will be default. Next, we need to select the loop through option. So we want to loop through specific rows. And what specific rows we want to loop? We want to loop through row number 2 to row number 11. So let's provide the options over here from row 2 to row 11. And the result, that is the details of row 2 to row 11, need to be assigned to a variable. So here we are going to create a variable and that will be a variable of type record. So this record variable we have already learnt in our previous session where we learnt about the Excel. So let's give the name as field data and this is a variable of type record. Let's click on create and select and let's click on apply. So under the loop we are going to provide the values of all these fields. So let's start to add the capture actions. So let's search for the capture action again. From the recorder, let's select this capture. Let's drag and drop it over here. And make sure that you have added this capture action under the loop. So if you move to flow view and if you see over here, this capture action is placed inside the loop. So make sure that this capture action is put inside the loop. So let's move to list view again and here we need to capture again. So let's select this window and from this drop down, let's select this RPA challenge. and let's click on Capture Object. So from here, let's select this company name. Let's click over here and it is getting captured. And it is done. The company name is captured. Now we need to take care of the object properties. So HTML tag is input, that's fine. Then the DOM XPath. So it has taken the XPath with the attribute ID, which is changing every time. So we need to take the XPath which we have created for the company name. So let's take this XPath. Let's copy it from here. Let's paste it over here. Next option we have is the HTML ID. It is dynamic in nature. I'm going to remove this one. This one also I'm going to remove. And the type, let's keep the HTML type as text. Path also is not required. Let's remove this one. And name also not required. Let's remove this one as well. So if I check what all properties we have selected, so you see again we have selected the 5 properties, out of which this HTML tag, DOM XPath, HTML types are there, control type and technology type are there. So only these 5 properties are required to capture the company name object. Next we need to select the action. So we need to set a text inside the company name. So let's provide the value over here. So press F2 and from the drop down let's select the field data variable which we just created of type record. So let's select this one and here we need to provide the value. So let's give the value as index. And what index is required? Since the value is provided from this spreadsheet, so we need to take the index from here. This one is in index 0, this one in 1 and this in 2. 0, 1 and 2. So let's provide the index as 2. Let's provide the index over here as 2. Let's click on yes, insert, and let's click on apply. So capture action is done for the company name. In a similar way, I'm going to add the capture action for all these fields. Let's copy it from here and let's paste it 7 times. And let's start to edit the object properties. So the window title and the window application path is going to be similar. No modification is required. Window title is going to be RPA challenge every time. Then we need to focus on the object properties. So let's provide the object property over here. We are done with the company name. Let's provide the company role. Let's copy it from here and let's paste it over here. And the company role also we need to set text. Next we need to provide the index. So the company role is in the index 3, that is 0, 1, 2 and 3. So the index is going to be 3 in this case. So let's provide the index as 3. And done. Nothing more changes are required. Let's click on apply. Let's move to the next capture and here let's take the first name. Let's copy it from here and let's move to properties and in the DOM XPath let's delete this one and let's paste the XPath which we created. And here we need to change the index, so the index will be 0 for the first name. Let's provide the index over here as 0. Let's click on apply. Let's move to this capture and we are going to take next as email. Let's move to object properties again. Let's delete this one. Let's put it over here. And email is at index 5. So let's take the index as 5. Let's click on apply. Next capture with us, we are going to provide the address. Let's move to object properties and let's change it to address. And the index value in this case is going to be 4. So it is at index 4. So let's take the index over here as 4. Let's click on apply. Next with us is phone number. So let's copy this one from here and again move to object properties. Let's remove this XPath. Let's paste it over here and let's provide the index for phone number, which is at index 6. So let's provide the index 6. Let's provide the index 6 over here. Click on apply. And the final one with us is for the last name. Let's copy this XPath. Let's change the DOM XPath from here. Let's paste the XPath which we created. And the last name is at index 1. So let's provide the index as 1. And let's click on apply. So all done, we have provided all the capture actions related to all the fields with the XPaths which we have created. Now the final step which we need to add is to click on this submit button. So let's add a capture action for submit button as well. And let's provide the details for the submit button. So first we need to select the window. So let's select this window and from this drop down, let's select this RPA challenge. And now we need to capture the object. So let's click on capture object. And from here, I'm going to select this submit button. And this is getting captured. And if I move to object properties, so let's see what all object properties we have. So HTML tag is fine. Then we need to change the DOM XPath. Let's delete this DOM XPath and I'm going to provide the XPath which we created. Let's copy this one from here and let's paste it over here. And next, this one also need to be unchecked. These are not required. HTML type is required, so I'm going to keep this. And this HTML path is not required, so I'm going to remove these one. So if I look at this now, what all properties we have finally. So again, we have the properties as control type, technology type, HTML tag, DOM XPath and HTML type. All looks good. Now the action we want to do is to click. So click on this drop down and select the click option from here. All good. So let's click on apply and let's save the bot. So here we completed our task to do the RPA challenge. So it's first of all, it's going to launch the website. Then it's going to open the spreadsheet which has the data. Let me open the spreadsheet for you. This is the spreadsheet from where it's going to take the field values. Next, we have the action to click on this start button. Then the loop is started to loop through the row number 2 to row number 11 from this spreadsheet. And the values of these fields will be stored inside a record variable which we have created. Then we are going to provide the values in all these fields from these capture actions. And at the end, we are going to hit this submit button. And at the end, the spreadsheet is getting close. So let's quickly run this bot to see how it works. So I'm going to close this spreadsheet and let's close this RPA challenge website and let's hit the run. And my bot is running now. The RPA challenge website is getting launched. And it hit the start button. Now the loop command is getting executed and the values are provided to the fields for round 1. So round 1 is over. Now the round 2 is in progress. Round 2 is done successfully. Now the round 3 is in progress and you can notice the positions for all these fields are getting changed every time. Now the round 4 is in progress. And here you see the round 5 is in progress. The positions is getting changed. And the XPath which we created are helping us to identify the elements properly. Round 6 is over. Now round 7 is in progress. Now the round 8 is in progress. Now this is the round 9. And this is the final round. And the bot ran successfully. It says your success rate is 100%. That is 70 out of 70 fields we provided correctly. So in this way, we completed this RPA challenge. We provided the values to all these fields which were changing in all the iterations. So you can also practice this one and let me know in case you face any queries. And that's all for this session, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, give it a like and share with your friends and hit the bell button to get the updates on the latest videos. And I will see you soon in the next one. Bye-bye.